Hey VC, what's up? It's me, yours truly. I am back to post a quick video here. This is going to be a quick response to your top 25 Metallica songs thread that's been going around. Hope you guys had a good Thanksgiving and all of that. You know, I was out of town for a little bit over a week, and I actually saw a number of people that posted videos to this. JC was one of the first ones that I saw that really just kind of got me pumped up with the idea. So I was kind of itching to get back and actually post one myself. So here we go. My top 25 Metallica songs. And I should actually put a little footnote on that. My top 25 Metallica songs as of this very moment. Because I know without a question, if you ask me 30 minutes from now to make the list from scratch, there'll be things that'll fall off and things that'll go on. I mean, it's Metallica, you guys know. So just as of this second, and I try not to overthink it too, because I thought if I set and actually went through it too much, it would drive me crazy. So I just kind of listed a bunch of songs that I really liked and just pulled them really quick and put them in order. And this is what I came up with. So let's just kind of jump right into it. Number 25, and I kind of have them all sitting in front of me here in order so I don't have to scooch around too much. So I got my list here to make sure I don't jump around. Number 25, I'm going to go with The Unforgiven by Metallica, off the Black Album. So of course everyone knows this album right here. You know, it's a fantastic album. It's the album that caused all the stir and, you know, blah blah blah. And there was one writer that wrote something that really kind of, I think, summed up the issue with this particular album. And he said the issue with it is that Metallica had so many hardcore fans and a lot of metal and stuff back then, especially, like, you know, it was your band, and like you know, it's like, it's my thing, it's what my parents don't get, it's what my friends, all my, you know, everyone at school doesn't get, where it's like, you know, it's just, I get this. And then he was like, overnight, all of a sudden, your 12-year-old sister was coming into your room going, can I borrow your Metallica album? and I just thought, like, that really does describe what drove people so crazy about the radio friendlier, if you will, you know, blah blah blah. But fantastic album, legendary album, you guys know it. But The Unforgiven is my pick there. Number 24, I won't take too much time with each one, otherwise this will take forever. But this is one I think maybe it's been a little bit forgotten. And it's off of Beyond Magnetic. Because, you know, after Death Magnetic came out, this 4-track EP came out. And there's a song on it called Just a Bullet Away. And it's a 7-minute track, and it's, I'm still kind of surprised Metallica didn't put it on Death Magnetic, because it was, I mean, a fantastic track. But yeah, so that's my number 24. It's Just a Bullet Away off of Beyond Magnetic. So I'd be curious, let me know if you guys heard this or not. There really wasn't much said about this when it came out. I mean, it was a 4-track EP. As you can see, I paid like $12.99 for it. I mean, these things are going for like over $100 now, so I'm actually kind of glad I kept it sealed. Because I had the CD as well. But yeah, just a Bullet Away, great track there. All right, so now we're gonna go to number 23, which is coming off of Load, and that's gonna be The House That Jack Built. Again, not one of the songs that got more of like the, you know, singles treatment or anything like that, but it's one of my favorite songs from the time I first heard this album. Just kind of a real cool groovy thing to it, you know, kind of a little bit of the voice box thing they did on the guitar solo and all of that. I just thought it was a really, really cool kind of just catch you in a groove kind of track. It was heavy more so than fast. So yeah, great album, great song. So The House That Jack Built. Number 22, we're going to this album here, which is, and the song we picked off of here was The End of the Line. Great album there. This is when first time I saw Metallica in concert was actually off of this album on this tour. So I've actually almost forgot I had those in there. Those are a couple of guitar picks I got from the concert that night. But the first time I saw them on that tour. But yeah, so The End of the Line, great track. Love it. Next, number 21. This is gonna throw a few people. but it's actually coming off of Saint Anger, and it's Some Kind of Monster. I think that is a freaking awesome track. I think there's a lot of great things on this album, period, even though it catches the flack that it's caught. And I still say to this day, I mean, of course, when you think Metallica, you have an expectation of something you want to hear. So if you get something totally different, it's more than easy to see how that can turn people off. But I think in general, the worst thing about this album, and I've said this so many times that many of you probably know what I'm getting ready to say right now, the worst thing about this album is not the overbearing snare drum and blah, blah, blah. It's the fact that that name is on the front of it. Because I still firmly believe in a parallel universe or something, if this album would have been put out by a band that was not known, if it was their debut album or something like that, it would have been a bit of a rage. It would have been, the reviews would have been something, oh, so fresh, so new, it's just kind of raw, it's not overproduced, it's just, you know, just getting back to basics and like blah, 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 blah. It would have been like all that type of chatter. But I think the minute you stamp Metallica across the front, it's like, oh, there's a whole different expectation. Now this sucks. And so that's not to say that, you know, if you don't like it, you don't like it, because of course, what rings in your ear is good and what doesn't ring in your ear, you forget. It's just, that's the nature of music. There's no wrong. But in my opinion, I think that's kind of what went down. So that's 21. Number 20. We are going back to, so I got my list over here on the side, make sure I'm staying on track. We're going back to King Nothing off of Load. So again, another great track off of that album. And you know, there's a number that I ended up leaving off too. I mean, but you guys know how it goes, is only 25 spots. So a lot of great stuff there. Let's see, number 19. Now we're going over to Reload. And I'm going with Fuel. Again, I think just another great hard-hitting song. Definitely a great one to hear live. I think it's fantastic. But yeah, another great one right there. I mean, if Metallica really wanted to, and I prefer more music than less, but if at the time, if they would have condensed Load and Reload to one album, I mean, just think about like how freaking gigantic that album would have been. It would have almost been like another slight Black album with just the hits between the two. But yeah, so Fuel, let's see, number 18, what did I put for 18? Oh, we gotta go back to Death Magnetic, and we're going with The Day That Never Comes. I think, again, great Metallica with the, you know, the soft intro, the nice, you know, beautiful guitar stuff, the build up, the explosion, blah, 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 just vintage Metallica at the time. So great song there. Number 17. You know, you gotta go to the Beast. You know, it's gonna be things you have to pull off of here, of course. And for the number, what was that again? Number 17, I went with The Thing That Should Not Be. So that's what I'm picking off of here. And again, it goes back to, you know, I love Metallica. Obviously, they were one of the godfathers of really exploding of the thrash and blah, blah, blah. But it's just sometimes when they get into just their slow, heavy grooves on stuff, that's the stuff that I really tend to like a lot. So there we go. And actually, I'm realizing I forgot to pull an album. Oh well, I'll just name that one. I mean, you guys will know it anyway. So yeah, I'm realizing I forgot to pull an album out of my Metallica stack here. So that was The Thing That Should Not Be at number 17. At number 16, we go back to another masterpiece off of Ride the Lightning, which is Fade to Black. Again, legendary song. Never tell you guys about that one at all. Let's see, number 15. And this one might be a little bit of a surprise to people. I'd be curious to know what people think about it, especially being at 15. I'm going to Hardwired and the song Atlas Rise. I mean, I think that is just a freaking awesome song. The drum and guitar riff on the intro just has like this, you know, explosion thing about to take place. I love James. I love his vocals, like his rhythmic vocals over the rhythm of the guitar in some of the verses, and then kind of in the area where they go into, not even necessarily the guitar solo, but just that little interlude, I don't know the exact language, where they kind of go back to that orchestral type of guitar rhythm thing that they did, which kind of, you know, reflects back to some of the older Metallica. I just thought it was a freaking great track. And there's a lot more on this, you know, with Moth to a Flame, Hardwired, and a bunch of other things too. So Atlas Rise makes my 15. Number 14. Having to go back a little earlier again. And we're going back to the Black Album, Wherever I May Roam. Again, I think that's an awesome track. Cool intro. The whole nine. Now we're on number 13. We'll go back to another masterpiece that kind of everyone, whether you listen to it a lot anymore or not, I mean, you still have to honor it as the amazing thing that it was. And it's One off of Injustice. I mean, really, One was the first thing I heard by Metallica away from the Black Album, because back in high school, the Black Album, I wasn't into thrash and that type of thing, and the Black Album was the first Metallica I'd ever really heard and listened to on a regular basis. And then, of course, the video for One was the my next venture away from, or my first venture away from the Black Album. Number 12. Gotta go with a little Seek and Destroy, and Kill 'Em All. Alright. And again, a number of great tracks that I left off of that album that didn't make my list as well. Number 11. We are going to go with... I don't know why I keep thinking this album is back there. Number 11. Harvester of Sorrow. Off of Justice. And again, it goes back to that rhythmic thing that I... Again, you know, you love the speed and the energy of the stuff Metallica did. But a lot of that rhythmic, just kind of power in your face stuff is just some of my favorite stuff by them. And Harvester of Sorrow is a great example of that. Okay, and number 10, and this is one of the albums I forgot to pull, Small Hours off of the 598 EP. I don't know why I forgot to pull that out, but Small Hours is definitely one of my favorite tracks. And actually, now that I think about it, I think it's on this. Is it on this too? Oh, yeah. Okay. So maybe that's what I did. I wasn't thinking about it. But on Garage Inc., the Small Hours is on that one as well. So I always think about it on the Garage. But, or on the EP. So yeah, Small Hours, same thing. Just kind of that, just pounding, slow, rhythmic type of stuff that I just find awesome. So now we're in the top 10. So that was 10. Number 9. Again, we're going back to Ride the Lightning, and we're going with For Whom the Bell Tolls. And all the things I just said about a lot of the last couple tracks I just mentioned. So, fantastic track there. It makes my number 9. And number 8. Got to go back to Master of Puppets with Battery. I mean, just pure energetic. And again, I'm not going to describe it because you guys know. Number 7. And this one might be a little bit of a surprise, so to speak. Especially if you consider some of the things that I feel like it beat out. But off of Death Magnetic, Broken, Beaten, and Scarred. That song kills to me. One of my favorite songs to listen to them in my car, because it's just like the energy of it and the groove of it. Even James's vocals, just like the way he delivers that. He sounds like he's singing just like every other song, but it's just something about the way he delivers the vocals on that song. Just sounds like his throat is about to explode. But yeah, Broken, Beaten, and Scarred, the energy of that, I just love it. So that works its way well up my list. At number 7. Number 6. A song I first heard the first time I went to see Rob Zombie, actually. And it's Whiskey in a Jar by Metallica. I mean, just a fantastic cover that they did of that. I mean, they do a number of great covers off of here with, you know, Stone Cold Crazy and Tuesday's Gone, that Lynyrd Skynyrd cover. I mean, just a lot of great things, but yeah, Whiskey in the Jar is just a great, great rock and roll song. And like I said, I went to see Rob's White Zombie, and you know, they're changing over the sets and they're playing songs and everything. And Whiskey in the Jar came on, and everyone's like just kind of, you know, really grooving to it and singing it. And I was like, I never heard this song. What is this? And I actually asked a guy that was standing next to me. He was like, yeah, it's Metallica, Whiskey in the Jar. And boom. And now it's coming in my number six. Number five. Well, you might as well stay here because Am I Evil? I mean, that Diamond Head cover, again, just the raw back to basics, like, this is where metal came from, kind of feel to the song and the way they covered it. I think it's just awesome. The guitar riff and that just kind of so simple and straight to the point. So love that. So Am I Evil comes in at five. Number four, in the top five now. Going back here and we're going with Blacken off of Injustice for All. You know, I mean, yeah, Blacken and Harvester of Sorrow are just the two songs off of this I just cannot stop listening to. For a lot of the reasons I've already explained with some of the other tracks. So that makes my number four. So the top three, and this might be a little interesting here too. And this may be, I don't know if it's, say it's cheating or not, but anyway, I'm gonna throw it out there because I consider it kind of a Metallica song. Ecstasy of Gold, which of course is what Metallica uses every single time they come out. And if you go back and look at some of the, like the DVD, like Some Kind of Monster, the making of, there was a couple of shots in there where it was actually like James was kind of singing it as the, you know, song was playing and that type of thing. And I know the moments that I've seen where I've heard him actually singing the, I mean, it's not words, but he's kind of doing the vocal thing. It's just like, oh my gosh. It's freaking epic to me. And I've always said, like, that song is so powerful that, that like, you know, if you had an event that was like as big as the world has ever seen, like, I don't know, like, Jesus Christ has come back to earth and he's going to give the sermon of all sermons to heal the entire world. Like, if it was something that epic that was going to happen, the Ecstasy of Gold would be the song that he would come out to. Like, it's just that big and that grand and that just kind of like, so yeah, a number of different versions I've heard over the years that Metallica uses or have done, and I think that's a fantastic track. Again, I don't know if that counts as a Metallica song, but it's the one of the ones I love hearing the most. So number two, any guesses? Number two, we're gonna go with Creeping Death, which is really kind of odd because for the longest time, Ride the Lightning, I mean, this is even after I discovered, you know, I went back and discovered Kill 'Em All and Master, and Ride the Lightning just never shot that high up. I mean, it was there, but it was never like, it wasn't the standout in my Metallica collection. And just a number of years ago, for whatever, it's just all of a sudden that album just started like, just like pounding into me what was so great. And Creeping Death was one that just kind of emerged, and it, I mean, really almost, as you can tell, became my favorite Metallica track. But yeah, the storytelling in it, of course, the energy in it, it's just freaking awesome. So Creeping Death at number two. And of course, number one, and it has to be number one, if it's my favorite metal song of all time, then of course it has to be my favorite Metallica song of all time. And it's the one and only Master of Puppets. Again, what can I say about that? So that definitely hits my number one. If you want to get even more specific, one of my favorite, or I say one of my top five concert moments in terms of watching videos of concerts and stuff like that, I should say maybe top 10, is the Seattle 89 concert. When they do Master of Puppets on that, I mean, if you just want to see what just the pure energy of what, in my opinion, just kind of what a concert is supposed to be like, with Metallica kind of being at their peak, in my opinion, it's like Seattle 89 was the concert, and they're a version of Master of Puppets on that. Just go check that video out. It's just one of my top 10 concert footage things of all time, without question. You know, other ones, just in case you're curious, since I'm rambling here, like some others that'd be on my top list there would be Queen doing Radio Gaga at Live Aid. Again, I think that's definitely one of my top three just rock and roll performances. What Mercury did that day on that stage and the way that he did, I'm getting chills just talking about it. I mean, it's just like, ladies and gentlemen, rock and roll. Like, I don't know what else to, I don't know, rock star right there. Would be a couple other good ones too. Was it Woodstock 2? When Korn came out and did Blind? Oh my gosh. I mean, there was a lot of crazy stuff that happened at the Woodstock, and I really kind of hate that they even associated the madness that happened at that with the original Woodstock and all of that, but that always kind of bothered me. I wish they would have called it something else. But man, when Korn came out and did Blind, and it was just like, if you go watch that video, it's so cool when the opening riff kicks in, because, you know, like the whole band is just on stage headbanging, and the people are just so packed in. It literally looks like water, and not like a bunch of little things jumping up, but it looks like just one flow of water. And you can tell how long it was taking the sound to travel, because it was just kind of a wave on the jump. It was just like, man, just like totally mind blowing. But anyway, that might be another fun video to do. It's like top 10 favorite concert moments, and that might be the next one that you see. So anyway, that's my top 25 Metallica songs. Ask me in a few minutes, I'll tell you something completely different probably. But as always, thanks for watching, VC, and let me know what you think. All right, take care, guys.